The Center for Behavioral Genetics at University of Novi Sad conducted research in order to study emotional reactions to ongoing pandemic in Serbia for 5 weeks. About 1,500 people participated in our research. The results have shown that at the beginning of the pandemic, the fear of infection was very pronounced. However, worry and fear of possible coronavirus infection gradually decreased over 5 weeks. What does that mean? While the situation is unfamiliar, people are finding new patterns of behavior which causes tension and uncertainty as they are unsure of the success of the new strategies. Over time, the experience of control over the situation increases and the tension decreases. This is an adaptation strategy, indicating a tendency of people to modify behaviors in accordance with negative circumstances. After 5 weeks of the coronavirus pandemic, people slowly adjusted, less worried and afraid. People show adaptability and flexibility important for coping with any disaster. This is an important lesson. We have learned that the involvement of the citizens in science is a step towards democratization and openness of science. People are motivated to help scientists solve relevant social problems, and that is one of important lessons. During the pandemic, the number of scientific papers on the topic of coronavirus increased, but most scientific publishers, big scientific publishers, decided to put all papers in the open access. According to the Web of Science, during this year, over 3,700 scientific papers on the coronavirus were published from different scientific fields. Almost all are in open access. The need to quickly access to scientific results forced big publishers to change their business model. Open science is a model that allows the exchange of scientific data, information, and knowledge. Scientific knowledge must become available to all, since science belongs to all people. That is an important lesson. The coronavirus has shown us that there are no boundaries, no races, no classes that are more important in the face of global disaster. Therefore, we all deserve governments that will take care of well-being, science that will be dedicated to well-being, societies that will be based on respect for diversity and well-being. It's impossible to predict the future. Still, we all know that the world will change. Poverty may become more pronounced, and the distribution of wealth even more unjust. But if we know what we want, we can all create the future. At an individual level, we can ask ourselves, do we continue to live as before coronavirus? Will we become frightened and obsessed with health? At the public level, we can ask how much is a human life worth? How public funds and resources are invested in? Will investing in the health systems and science become a priority? Will we protect vulnerable social groups from economic crisis? Will ethics and human values have to become paramount in politics and governance? Behind each of these questions is a choice. The choice between the world as it is and the world as it could be. We all will create the world after the coronavirus. This is an optimistic and perhaps unrealistic expectation that we need wise questions, humane choices, and smart decisions. We need universal health coverage, more healthcare professionals, more investments in science, and social policies based on general security, appropriate education, work, and well-being conditions for all people. Investment in unprofitable scientific disciplines such as medicine, ecology, social work can be an economic risk, but the coronavirus has shown the consequences of such a strategy. General health care must be a priority of our civilization. Every person deserves a minimum of dignity in the form of provided health care and living conditions. Creating conditions for coping with the crisis implies a health-educated population. Therefore, educated people with health habits and the community which provide adequate support to citizens are the starting points for dealing with potential crises. It also means nurturing empathy and raising awareness of the importance of the support we provide to each other. Important resources in dealing with potential crises are scientific achievements. What is the basic purpose of science? I think we all agree that science has the task to create a better world. Therefore, technological progress is not enough. Technological development is important, but it only helps us achieve more important goals. Technological development must create the conditions for advances in the medicine, social sciences, and arts. This progress can help people to nurture morality and tolerance. Social sciences help us to understand that all people are different. We must stop hating diversity provoked by all sources of borders, since individual differences are the basic condition for our survival on this planet. Therefore, we have to nurture the diversity and adopt new approach towards the role of social sciences in society. If we strive to create a society that has strong social policies based on high ethical standards, society that invests in physical and mental health of citizens, we can cope with any crisis.